Welcome to Alien Isolation.
And hello.
Did you see what I did there? Usually I say hello first.
And welcome to the video second.
I bet you weren't expecting that.
But expect the unexpected, because anything can happen.
These videos are crazy. Something just exploded.
Oh God. And there's Guy on Fire. Hello, Guy on Fire.
You're one of those androids, aren't you?
Wow.
And now, bits of wall
are coming out of the walls.
Oh no, you're not.
I have a plan, and it's as hot as your pants. It's to wait in here, and then go past you. Your footprints are leaving fire everywhere. Stop it.
No wonder the walls are getting angry. And speaking of which, oh dear, he's coming after me. I bought an adorable book. It's called Jonesy, which basically tells the story of the ship's cat in Alien. Whilst everyone was running around looking for the alien, what was Jonesy doing? Well, being a cat, getting in the way, scratching the padded walls. Ow. It's just one of those cute, funny little books, and I couldn't resist it. And we've got an alien to deal with. What are you doing over there?
I didn't say you could be over there,
but I'd rather him be over there than be over here, because if he was here, he'd be trying to kill me. Trying to eat my face.
And
I'd rather he didn't, because I need that.
I need it for doing facial expressions. I have 3 facial expressions: happy, bewildered, and default.
All with different eyebrow variations.
My eyebrows kind of give me away when I'm lying to my boss about why I'm late for work. I saved a crying child, and then I was kidnapped by an alien. There he is.
I haven't used the kidnapped by an alien excuse yet, but I'm pretty sure it will work. I'll do it next time. Look at him. Whoa, you're getting a bit close. Go away!
No.
I'm trying to abandon the station, but the alien won't get out of my way.
Come on.
He's just admiring the burning seats. I guess that's evidence that the working Joe was sitting down when he should be working. I'm afraid he's in very serious, grave, deep trouble, and he's on report.
But for now, this is my chance. Seriously?
The alien's back, he was only gone for about 2 seconds.
Stupid indecisive git.
Where is he? There he is. Stomping around, being all menacing. We need a passcode. I don't have a passcode. Well, he's gone.
And flamer fuel. Thank you.
Evacuate station. This is not a drill.
This is a drill.
References.
To be honest, I bet in my audience there's only about 2.5 people that actually get the references I make. But it's always fun when people point them out. But my videos are always full of silly little things just to see if anyone spots them. Now, I saw a code. 1984. What a year.
Ghostbusters, Gremlins, Terminator, Stay Hungry by Twisted Sister.
I can't think of anything else, but I'm sure it was a brilliant year. And now, if we can find that thing on the wall, we can input the passcode.
After evacuation, you cannot re-enter the station. Tell advised to do so by the orbital emergency convener.
Why would I want to re-enter the station after evacuating?
I don't want to be here. It's rubbish. This place is full of death.
1984. And we have a key card. Where do I use that? I haven't seen the alien for a few seconds. He's being nice to me. And somehow we need to get all the way over there and find an alternative route to the spaceflight terminal. I don't think I've seen anywhere to use a card, unless I have to go back where I was, down that corridor. Let's have a quick look. Oh, fire. Why can't people be more like you? Ooh, I see more dead bodies I didn't see before. But is there a key card reader around here? That's what I need.
Revolver ammo?
I don't need revolver ammo. I need flamer fuel. The alien laughs at revolver ammo. Mockingly. But it fears the flamer fuel. Ah. And we have found the place to use our key card. Now, what's this do? I've done something. I hope that doesn't attract the alien. Now what? Something happened, but I don't know what. Oh, great. Well, hopefully the alien stays away for a bit longer, so I can find out. Do I have to go back the way I came? I'm trying, but I'm lost. Okay, let's try going through that vent that we saw before. Or maybe... I don't know. We have to go this way, so let's go towards the save point. There's a person there. He's not on fire anymore. Which is good, but I need to get past him. Are you gonna move? Come on! Move! If you don't move, I'm going to have to walk past you!
Did I say walk? I mean run! You can't get me!
Strange. It's Doctor! Now let's see if I missed anything in here! This is where Sevastopol probably keeps its diamonds!
Full of treasure!
Ow. SCJ injectors. Bonding agent. All the stuff I don't need. Well, maybe I could make some things and pick it all up.
Ah, all right then.
Let's make some stuff. So, we've got... Molotov, we need some of those.
Oh, I hear the alien.
I'm not scared of you. I've seen the alien on his downtime, sending Facebook messages to his mate Predator. Now, I can't make an EMP mine, but I can make a noisemaker. Item constructed. One thing I've been doing recently is collecting soundtracks and things.
I have so many.
I got all the obvious ones, the ones I had to get, like all the Star Wars soundtracks, Lord of the Rings, Harry Potter, loads of Tim Burton, Danny Elfman stuff, loads of Disney movies, horror movies, Hellraiser series, of course all the Alien films. Actually, that's weird. I never noticed how much the Never Ending Story soundtrack sounds like something from Final Fantasy.
It's so 80s, but I love it.
Actually, Never Ending Story came out in 1984 as well.
Ah, there's another one.
But of course, I have to collect game soundtracks as well.
Resident Evil, Metal Gear Solid, Final Fantasy.
Loads of the games I've LP'd. And some other stuff like Medieval, which I hear is getting an HD remake soon.
Yes!
Tomb Raider has some great soundtracks, so I got those.
Portal, the Batman Arkham series.
And even though it's not the kind of music I usually listen to, I managed to get the PlayStation 1 demo music. That sort of 90s trance type thing. But it's so nostalgic, and I love that.
And though there's many more I can mention, in a roundabout way, without beating around the bush, because I wouldn't do that, and I believe in getting straight to the point...
Oh look, it's an android!
Hi!
Hope you don't mind, I'm gonna have to walk past you now. Maybe I could push him over.
Hey.
Now, let's go.
Yeah, I was gonna say, I also have the music and everything for Alien Isolation. I don't think enough could be said about how amazing the sound design is in this game. I mean, believe me, there's a lot of just drones and weird eerie ambiences. But it's amazing how much work went into it.
It wasn't enough just to get the soundtrack. I wanted to get some of the weird ambiences as well.
Like when we was in the alien hive and we started hearing all those weird alien screams from in the distance.
That was awesome.
Kind of creepy.
But not just those.
Now at my leisure, I can listen to loads of classic Alien Isolation sounds.
Like who could ever forget this one?
And this.
And this. Lovely.
I think we've found where we need to go.
Ah.
How did I miss this?
I mustn't have been paying attention.
Oh my god! Yay! I found a thing. I like things.
But alas, I cannot pick up the thing, so I must go.
If I could just go around picking up everything I wanted, I'd be collecting all the traffic cones. To confuse the alien, and the alien's gonna be wandering around,
oh, where's the traffic cones?
And it'll serve him right for all the times he's tried to kill me. Him and all his alien friends.
Now, I feel before we go in here,
Let's see what's down in the other direction. Just in case there's something awesome. I don't like this corridor. It's dark. If I see somebody with a red lightsaber, I'm running. So far, so good. Nope, nothing. Nothing horrible, just items. And a dead guy. He died doing what he loved, being eaten to death. He didn't really have anything good to pick up though, so he deserved to die. You know who didn't though? Ricardo. He was my friend. It's just really inconvenient that he died because I was going to start a club with him, was going to escape and was going to have t-shirts saying, I survived Sevastopol. There'd be weekly meetings. It was going to be brilliant. There was going to be biscuits. But now we can't. So instead I'm going to have to just walk down this corridor of death. This big, wide, open, long corridor. There could be aliens. Although, since I escaped the Hive, I haven't seen multiple aliens. There were so many down there. All of them rather nasty. They burst out of their human hosts, a first kill of many, and rapidly grew into the hostile creatures we're hiding from now. And to be honest, I put that down to bad parenting. If I ever have children, which is unlikely because I spend all my time making videos, I shall make it my priority that they don't grow up to be the sort of people to run up and eat someone's face without asking. It's the height of rudeness. No child of mine will do that. Although soon, I am going to become an uncle. And I have to say, I was rather impressed with the 4D baby scan photos. They actually look like something, as opposed to the little black and white blurry photos that we all got. I can confirm my nephew is not an alien, but in fact, a human. Or so it appears. Whoa, no entry. Just who does that wall think it is telling me where I can and can't go? Okay, so we've got some items to pick up. I never say no to items. Unless it's something stupid like flares. I've had absolutely no use for flares in this game. Unless you can use them to scare the alien. I don't know, I've never tried that. But I'm not sure if it's worth it. I mean, I've been playing this game so well, I haven't died once. Well, maybe once. But nobody noticed. I think I got away with it. Ugh, even this place is on fire. Oh, flame fuel. That's just what I've always wanted. Christmas is coming up, and if you have no ideas what to get me, bring me flame fuel. Actually, that would be kind of weird, opening your presents and getting flame fuel. I was only expecting a pair of socks. Now, have you got anything interesting?
No, you don't.
And that is why you are dead. Did you not hear me? I said I want flame fuel, not ethanol.
Up with this, I will not put.
You have failed me for the last time.
Proceed to evac.
These computers and automated voices think it's so easy.
I bet when they built Sevastopol, they didn't even consider there'd be a giant alien. What do I have to deal with the jerk monsters? Why can't I have nice ones, like pocket monsters?
I just saw the newly released trailer for the Pokemon movie. Deadpool has become a Pikachu. It looks like a sort of Dr. Doolittle take on Pokemon, and some people are kind of on the fence about it. People who played all the games and grew up with it, their opinion's gonna matter more than mine, because although I really liked the cartoon when I was a kid, I never got to play the games, so I don't quite have the same nostalgic love. Whilst everyone else was playing Pokemon, I was playing Final Fantasy VII. So, as a sort of casual fan that enjoyed the anime when I was little, I thought the trailer to this film looked actually quite appealing. It's nice seeing all the Pokemon animated realistically. And admittedly, I'm drawn by the fact that it's Ryan Reynolds doing the voice. I saw the trailer left me smiling. Sadly, I was only smiling for about 3 seconds because then I scrolled down on Facebook and then read the news about Stan Lee.
Aww.
Rest in peace, Stan Lee. I just bought all the DVDs of- Oh, wait. Ah! Ha! Nice try! Stupid facehugger.
On the team. We've sealed the habitation sanctuary. There's one way in, one way out. I've still got raiding parties heading out to loot supplies and weapons, but it looks like we shut it off just in time. The Sikhs and synthetics have started moving away from their stations. I've seen a trail of strangled bodies in public areas. So, be aware. Oh, and if you're listening to this and you're not on the team, don't come find us. We will shoot.
Whoa, that guy doesn't sound nice.
Oh, no! It's the alien. Right, we better hide. Where's he gone?
This isn't good.
Uh-oh. Where is he? I think he's over there. I need to try and make a break for it. Get to that door. Okay,
let's risk it.
He's nowhere to be seen. Good. If I can't see him, he can't see me. And as I was saying, I bought all the Phase 3 Marvel Cinematic Universe films in a nice big box set. So that's Civil War, Doctor Strange, Guardians of the Galaxy 2, Spider-Man Homecoming, and the one that I can't wait to watch again, Thor Ragnarok. I really like that one. I haven't seen these films since I was at the cinema, so it'll be good to marathon them all. I haven't had time. I've been busy doing stuff and going to gigs. I went to go and see a really good Genesis tribute act focused on the prog rock early era. I both admire and envy really, really talented people, and they were awesome and inspiring. I wish I could write music like that. I kind of feel it's the thing to strive for, the ultimate goal. If I could write one song that's as good as something on, say, Queen's second album, that'd be something to be proud of. I'll just have to keep trying until I get there. One day. Now, I think we're getting close. Uh-oh. Where'd he come from? Go away! You stupid alien! He ran away. And now I need to refuel my flamethrower. How dare he appear out of nowhere. Okay, that door's locked, and... Oh, what have I done? Restart the generator. The generator? Do I have to go back where I was?
Oh, God.
Scary sounds.
Where is he?
Oh! That wasn't very nice. Ugh. And now I suppose the alien is going to high-five me in the face. Okay, let's try that again. Find an alternative route to the space flight... The space flight. It's a fantastic new word I've invented. Space flight. I often write when I'm recording. We're going to find a way to the space flight terminal. And this time, I didn't get seen by the alien. I don't want to speak too soon, but I didn't waste all my flamer fuel, so that's good. Can I make it to the switch?
Come on.
Where is he? He's over there. Okay. Let's try and do this, and hopefully he won't see me. Okay, so that door doesn't open. I need to try and get to the generator, which I believe is in the room we was in before. So let's go back down the corridor of doom!
The corridor of doom and death.
If I can get past this doorway, we are making progress.
Okay.
I don't see him. I don't really want to sneak all the way. I want to try and get there quickly, so let's risk... just walking there. I'm not going to run, because that is when he'll definitely hear me. Ugh.
I'm starting to not feel very well.
Stupid illness, making me all ill. Oh, what's going on? What? Oh yeah, of course.
I thought the way was blocked.
But no.
The path is clear, the only thing blocked is my nose.
I'm trying to speak as clearly as possible, but... eventually I'm gonna sound like I've got a blocked nose. I'll try not to, though.
I blame it on people!
If
If I didn't have to associate with them, I'd be fine. Maybe somebody at the gig made me ill. I got stuck standing behind some nutter who was standing just a little bit too close. It was weird. I mean, most people are fine. There's like an etiquette to go into a gig. It's unspoken, but everyone knows. You give people their personal space. You don't lean into people. That's just weird. I tried to move away, and this weirdo pretty much followed me. He kept talking and turning around and looking at me instead of the band. And more annoying than anything, he was stood in front of me, and he was really tall. As in the way tall. And him and his friends were all smoking too. Yuck. I bet the xenomorph will be kind of annoying to stand behind at a gig. Not only is the alien very tall, but whilst you're trying to enjoy the band, the alien's busy trying to eat the band. Which is another unspoken rule of gig etiquette. When you go to a gig, don't eat the band. The inconvenience distraction of having a hole in their head might make them play a wrong note. Okay, we've done it. What's that done? Find alternative route to space flight terminal. Okay, maybe that door's open now. So we have to go down the corridor of death. Feels kind of risky going down this middle section. I'm kind of out in the open. Uh-oh. I hear the alien. Where is he? Is he around this corner? Can't see anything.
Oh god.
I don't see him, so let's risk walking. He'll be fine.
I hope.
Okay, I don't see him. But I'm just gonna sneak down past these windows in case he sees me.
I can't die now.
I'm nearly so close. I need to escape. We're going to get on the torrens and get out of here. Okay. Let's save it, just in case. I don't want to go down the corridor of doom again. Now we just need to find out if the door over here is open. Otherwise, we will have to backtrack. Ooh, it is open. Great. Now, what's in here? Okay, we've got a recorder, some dead guy, an ID tag, and lots of stuff to pick up. Okay. Nothing too interesting.
I've made a couple of items already in this video.
I'm not going to make any more. I wish we could somehow make flamer fuel. That would be useful. Okay, let's see what this is. Be there soon. Alright, before we go in the lift, let's just quickly. So it's. Oh no! No, 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 no! Get lost! You jerk! Yes. Back off! No? Okay, fine, don't back off. I'm gonna have to burn you!
Why?
Why did I come over here? There's nothing here. Ah! Okay, let's just go. I think I'm gonna end this video here, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time for part 25. Bye!